Good morning, students. Welcome to Basic Electrical Lectures. And today's class is number 6. Okay, in this class, we are going to study the Kirchhoff laws. Okay, please give thumbs up to our videos. Then we can start Kirchhoff laws. See, the Kirchhoff law is proposed by the German physicist Gustav Robert Kirchhoff. The scientist name is Gustav Robert Kirchhoff. So this scientist proposed two laws to analyze electrical circuits. So the laws are named as Kirchhoff's current law and then Kirchhoff's voltage law. And these laws are very simple to analyze electrical circuit because these laws are mainly based on writing simultaneous equations. So we know how to get solution for simultaneous equation for two variables and three variables. Nowadays we can find solution by using calculators directly. Okay. Otherwise we have to use Cramer's rule. Okay. Like we can start. The German scientist proposed this law. Okay. Kirchhoff law. First one is KCL. Kirchhoff's current law. So the public will going to call different names for KCL for their understanding purpose. They are going to call this as node law, NODE, node law. So some people, public will call node law, or some will call junction law. Okay, junction law, and otherwise it is point law. Used according to the Kirchhoff's current law. So what it states? It states, you just copy down, the algebraic sum of all the currents meeting at a point or junction or a node is equal to zero. I will repeat again, the algebraic sum of all the currents meeting at a point or junction or node is equal to zero. This is one definition. And another definition is, the algebraic sum of all the currents entering to a node is equal to the currents leaving from the node. In simplest way, the sum of entering currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. Like we can solve this by we can understand this by example. So you can copy down the definition by pausing the video, what I dictated. Okay. Then you can take some currents I1, okay, I2, I3 and I4. All these currents I1, I2, I3, I4 are entering to this point. So this is called point or a junction or node. Okay, all are same. Now I5, I6, I7 and I8. All these currents are leaving from the node. So what I given now, first definition, the algebraic sum of all the currents meeting at a point is equal to zero. So in that definition, what are all the currents are entering to the node are taken as positive sign, and what are all the currents leaving from the node are taken as negative sign. So that I am going to write it now. What are the currents entering? I1 is entering, I2 and I3 plus I4. All the currents are entering to this node. Then, if the currents leaving from the node, you take negative sign. Minus I5 current is leaving from the node. So take minus I5, leaving, minus I6, leaving, minus I7, leaving, minus I8 is equal to 0. This is first definition. The algebraic sum of all the currents meeting at a point would add up to 0. Okay. Next, second definition. So what are all the negative currents are there? You take all that to right hand side. Then this becomes I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4 is equal to I5 plus I6 plus I7 plus I8. So this is second definition. The sum of currents entering to the node, the sum of current entering to the node is equal to the sum of current leaving from the node. So that is what second definition. So in Viva they will ask, okay, in basic electrical laboratory you will get this question. So you can tell in or in general, okay, sum of entering currents, is equal to sum of outgoing currents. Sum of entering currents or sum of outgoing currents. Outgoing currents or leaving currents, whichever is convenient for you, you can so follow it. So another one is important. Note, KCL is just restatement of conservation of charge. KCL is just a restatement of conservation of charge. So this question asked in Viva, okay, basic electrical lab. Okay, this is about Kirchhoff's current law. Like, we are going to check how we are going to apply this. So I will take one example. So it is a resistor of 10 ohms. So 4 ampere current is entering here, 3 ampere current is entering here, and another 3 ampere current is entering to this node, and some currents outgoing. My question is, you have to calculate what is power dissipated in this 10 ohm resistance. So how to calculate? Apply KCL. I don't know this current. Let you take this current as high. So now, what are the entering currents? 4 is entering, plus 3 is entering, plus 3 also entering. This is what is the outgoing current? I only. Add all this, you will get current value 10 amperes. What is power formula? I square R. Okay, power formula is I square R. What is current? 10 square. Into what is the resistance? 10. So you will get 1000 watts. So in this way, the KCL is applicable while analyzing the electrical circuits. So don't worry, after the theory, we will solve problems. From that, you can easily understand how we are going to apply Kirchhoff current law. Okay, got it guys? Understood? So pause the video and then copy down. So next part is Kirchhoff's voltage law. So copy down. It states that what I am dictating, that you get copy down. It states that the algebraic sum of all the EMF sources and individual potential drops. It states that the algebraic sum of all the EMF sources and the individual potential drops taken with proper sign convention, taken with proper sign convention would add up to zero. Okay, Kirchhoff's voltage law. So in any closed circuit, starting you add onward, okay, it states that in any closed circuit, the algebraic sum of all the EMF sources and individual potential drops taken proper sign convention would add up to zero. Okay, that is the statement. So very, very important. So public will call this is a loop analysis or mesh analysis. Okay, fine. Next, look at here. As I said in the definition, it is applicable only for closed loop circuit. It is applicable only for closed loop. So I have taken an example. Okay, let me take this R1, R2, R3, and R4, plus and minus. Let you call this voltage source E1 and this will be called as E2. So guys, see now it is a closed circuit. So definitely current starts going in this particular loop. We don't know whether current going clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So for that we should assume some direction. We have full liberty to assume our own direction. See guys, suppose if E2 was not there, you can find current in this particular loop by knowing Ohm's law itself, because the circuit is excited by independent voltage source, one voltage source. All our connected in series, voltage by resistance will get current. Whenever you have in a circuit more than one EMF sources, then you can find solution by Kirchhoff's law. Here, that is KVL. See, this is a EMF source. Polarity of the EMF source is fixed. Bigger one is positive, smaller one is negative. So, why that indicates? It indicates the polarities of the battery, anode and cathode plates of the battery. Okay, hence we are marking standard representation plus and minus. Okay, so now we can take our own direction. For simplicity, I am taking clockwise direction. Okay, some current I flow in this direction. This is my assumed direction. So before applying KVL, you must know the sign convention. So for that, you remember KVL rules. Remember the KVL rules. Okay, first one, we have resistor in the circuit. Okay. So due to some assumed direction of current, this is coming from assumed direction. So if that current is entering the resistor, mark it as positive. If the current leaves the resistor, mark it as negative. How I mark this polarity is based on assumed direction of current. Now you take this one, plus and minus and R. Remember, resistor is a bidirectional element. It can receive current in either direction. So therefore, so this polarity is fixed due to some assumed direction. If some other current flows for a resistor, if the current starts flowing from plus to minus, then you should write voltage drop. Then you must write voltage drop. That is written as minus I into R. So whenever for a resistor, if the current flows from plus to minus, you remember this one. Okay, minus IR, voltage drop. Then next for a resistor, plus and minus and R. Now if the current flowing from, because it receives current in either direction, if the current flowing from minus to plus, then you must write voltage rise. Voltage rise denoted by I into R. So this current into resistance will get voltage drop or voltage rise depending on the sign convention. Okay, got it? So remember, see how I mark this polarity is based on assumed direction. If some other current flows for that polarity, you may get voltage rise or voltage drop. Okay, remember this rule for resistor. What is there in our circuit? Another EMF sources there. So that you can apply over here. Next, second one is EMF source. Okay, EMF source. So the polarity of the EMF source is independent of loop direction. The polarity of EMF source will not modify based on your assumed direction. It is fixed. Bigger one is positive, smaller one is negative. And this EMF source, if it delivers the current, then it acts like a battery. If it receives the current, it acts like a load. Okay? So got it? So now, for this EMF source, if the current flows from, plus to minus, then you must write minus E. Similarly, for a EMF source, plus to minus, if the current is flowing from, if the current flows from minus to plus, then you must write plus E. Now this is also called battery acts like a source. It delivers current. Now this battery receives the current, then this battery acts like a load. Okay. In other way, it is the representation for generator and it is representation for motor. Okay. If motor requires electricity, it receives current. So we can consider this as motor, and generator delivers current. Okay. It develops voltage, that voltage source drives current to the external circuit. Then it is called generator. Okay. Ideally, you can think about this. If the current flows from minus to plus, this yellow source acts like a battery. Battery acts like a source. And if current flows from plus to minus, this yellow source acts like a load. Okay, got it? Fine. So now, by knowing these rules, we can easily apply KVL on this circuit. Okay, now, mark the convention. See this current. For this assumed direction of current, look at here. You can start from anywhere. So current is entering here, mark plus, leaves negative. Current is entering the resistor, mark plus, leaves negative. Don't modify this, fixed. Polarity of EMF sources, fixed. Again, current is entering here, mark plus, leaves negative. Same current is enters here, mark plus, leaves negative. So sign convention is done. Now apply KVL to loop. Okay, only one loop is there. You can start from anywhere. Start from EMF source. Or here or anywhere. Now see this current, see this polarity. For EMF source, current is flowing from minus to plus. What I should write? For EMF source, current is flowing from minus to plus. What should I write? Plus E. Very good. Then what I should write here? Plus E1. Okay. If you not, the plus will be there. Then for a resistor, current is flowing from plus to minus. For a resistor, current is flowing from plus to minus. What I should write? Voltage drop. Minus Y, what is the resistance value? R1. Then plus to minus. Current is flowing from plus to minus. Minus I R2. EMF source. Current is flowing from plus to minus. See what I should write? Plus C or minus C? Minus. What is the value? E2. Then plus to minus drop. Minus I R3. Plus to minus drop. Minus I R4 is equal to 0. Don't forget to write 0. Okay, look at here. In any closed circuit, the algebraic sum of EMF sources and the individual potential drops taken with proper sign convention, would add up to 0. Now you can take some values. Take this value of 10 ohms. Okay, 5 ohm, 6 ohm, 4 ohm, 10 ohm, 5 ohm. Now enter the value. What is this value? 10. Minus. What is R1? 6 I. Okay. Minus. What is R2? 4. 4 I. Minus. What is E2 value? 5 ohm. Minus. What is R3 value? 10. So 10 I. Minus. What is R4 value? 5. Minus 5 I. Equals to 0. 10 minus 5? 5. Minus 6, minus 4, minus 10, minus 20, minus 25, I. Equals to 0. Therefore, I is equal to 5 by 25. What is 5 by 25? 1 by 5 ampere. Guys, after applying KVL, if we got the loop current value positive, that indicates your assumed direction is correct. Otherwise, incorrect. Okay. So, if you change the direction, you will get same numerical value, but sign changes. Okay. Practically, you should not get negative currents. Okay. You should get positive values of the loop currents. But we don't know how the current will flow in this circuit, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. That purpose, we assume some direction. For that direction, if I got positive value of current, that indicates your assumption is right. Okay. Otherwise, wrong. Okay, guys. Pause the video and copy down. Okay. Now I am going to change the direction. Now change the direction. Okay, look at here. Now, initially I have taken Now current starts flowing in and take clockwise direction. Let's see what the solution will become. So current is entering the system, what plus leaves negative. Entering plus leaves negative. For polarity, don't modify. Entering resistor, leaves negative. Entering resistor plus leaves negative. Now apply KVL for the circuit. You can start from anywhere. Start from your source. See, for your source, current is flowing from plus to minus. What I should write? Minus even. So minus even. Then plus to minus drop. I R4. Minus I R4. Already that term is there. Okay. Then plus to minus drop. IR3, that term is there. Then see this current going from minus to plus for your source. What I should write? Plus E2. Then see this current going from plus to minus for resistor. What I should write? Drop. Minus IR2. That term is written. Then plus to minus drop. Minus IR2 equals to 0. Now enter the values. E1 minus 10. Okay, E2 is plus 5. Sorry. Okay, now simplify this. Minus 10 5, minus 5. Minus 5 is equal to 25 I. Okay. Now, minus 5 is equal to plus 25 I. Now, I is equal to minus 5 by 25. What is minus 5 by 25? Minus 1 by 5 ampere. See, you got same answer, only sign change. If we got your assumed direction, the current value, loop current value negative means that says your assumed direction is wrong. Please change the direction. Okay. But don't change it and redo again. Don't do that. Simply stop it here. Within the bracket, write here. For to change the direction to get positive value of current. That's it. You write within the bracket, change the direction to get positive value of current. That is more than sufficient. So make a note point. If we get positive value of loop current for our assumed direction, that indicates assumed direction is right, correct. Okay. Otherwise, incorrect. Means for assumed direction, if we get negative value of loop current as an answer, that indicates you should change the direction. Okay, got it? So that is the first note point. Next, the second note is KVL is just a restatement of conservation of energy in Viva Devas. Okay. KVL is restatement of conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. They will confuse you in Viva. Conservation of charge and conservation of energy. KCL or KVL. They will confuse like that. So you remember, current, charge, voltage, energy. Okay. See, once you apply KVL, remember, each and every term should be voltage only. What is E1? Volt. Current into resistance, voltage. Current into resistance, voltage. E2, voltage. Current into resistance, voltage. Current into resistance, voltage. KVL means every term should be voltage. So called voltage law. Okay. What is the purpose we are using this? To find the loop current. To determine current in particular loops. Okay, got it? So in the next video we can see problems on this topic. Okay guys, give thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, share the videos as many friends you know.